next year?
I love these. My thinking cap is going on. I love what everybody's turning in. They're wonderful. Please keep them coming. I have Best in Wheel Warrior over here. Yes. This is Tanna, and she is gorgeous. She's still a baby. She's only just about a year old. She's a terrier mix, and as you can see, she had an issue when she was just a baby, and so she uses wheels to get around because her back legs don't work exactly as they should. But let me tell you, this girl should not be pitied, because the second I let go of this leash, she would be running around this house times 10. If you're watching this video, you can see she loves her wheels and runs around like a crazy little girl. She's such a sweetheart. She would actually be best in a home with other dogs because she would love a play friend. She's very energetic. Of course, because of her back wheels, she would need somebody that's used to working with special needs or interested in learning how to be a mommy or daddy to a special needs rescue. But she is such a pretty girl and has so much love to give, loves giving kisses, loves treats, and again, just a high energy little lover. So please find out more at savingcaninelivesplus.org. She smells something right about here. I can see her looking at it. But again, her name is Tanna. She was adopted and then returned, and so she would love a second chance at love and life. So please go online to find out more, or head to your local rescue or shelter. There are so many wonderful animals, whether they're special needs or not, that would love an adoption ever after. And really, nothing completes a family like a wonderful pet.
Thank you so much, Larissa. We certainly hope that cutie finds a home. Meanwhile, we've made our way into the kitchen with our first guest, and it is always a good old time when she stops by. Today,
you know it.
It's already started, I told
already.
You. Today, she is making classic Valentine's Day Linzer cookies. Yes. Please welcome back to our home, Danielle Cartez.
Thank you so much. I love you both. You're my absolute all-time favorite people. I just love you.
Even more so than Nick Lachey, because when Nick Lachey was the last time.
Don't put me in that position.
She got a little nervous cooking for Nick Lachey. It was a little bit of a surprise.
It was
no
good,
surprises
it was good.
Today.
So, Nick, if you're out there, happy Valentine's for me and my husband.
You and your beautiful wife and family.
Yes, 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 yes.
So, Cam, Kim, and Ken are at the counter.
Like that's right.
Kim.
We sound like Ken. A boy band.
You are.
We all match
wonderfully.
I love this.
So, you're going to teach us how to make the classic Linzer cookies, which are so,
so Valentine's.
So
like,
they're Valentine's-y.
Perfect for this day. And I love Valentine's, you guys. I cannot get enough of it. I'm not kidding. If you can make a heart shape out of everything, I'm like cutting with a little knife or making it all cute.
Sweet.
I really like that. And my kids love it too. Like they really look forward
See?
To it.
So this is a traditional Austrian cookie though, right?
It is. And we've sort of, the American way is to sort of like remake everything. So we've sort of remade it. It's not the classic tart anymore. We've subbed raspberries for those classic currants.
Okay.
And we've got the almond flour that is, hails back to the tart, which is kind of fun. And then we make the cookie. Which is so cool.
And it's pretty simple to make.
It's so
simple. They look fancy, but they're really not that hard.
They're very simple. If you have some cookie cutters and, like two wits, you can totally do this.
All right, let's do it.
Okay.
I know three wits, so
okay.
I should be ahead of
myself. This is good. I have kind of a half, so I don't know. Okay.
So it starts with butter and sugar cream.
It totally does. And this is already creamed. Then we're going to add our egg and our vanilla. See, because you already told us.
All right, there you go.
And then... And here's a fun tip. It's nice to actually do this slow. So people never really think about creaming the butter and the sugar and the egg together. If you do it slower, you're going to get much more of a tender cookie. Ooh. So sometimes people are like, why is my cookie tough?
Right.
That's because you have over-creamed or done it too fast. So you can speed it up a little
there
bit.
You go.
And we'll scrape down.
Okay.
And then we're going to slowly add.
And it's only one egg. That's it.
It's only one egg. Oh, yeah. Huh.
All right. And that whole thing. So we'll slow down a little bit.
Like slow down. Isn't that fun? So we're going to add our flour.
And this is just regular basic flour?
This is just regular all-purpose flour.
Okay.
And then we're going to do almond flour, too. And the almond flour, we got a little bit going on here.
Yeah, why the combo?
So why both?
I'm curious.
Because an original Linzer tort has that delicious flaky almond. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like it's got the almond in it and it really makes the crust incredible.
It really does.
Yeah. And if you want to do a gluten-free cookie, you're not going to want to do all almond flour because it will crumble and fall apart. You want to pick up... one of those one-to-one baking mixes that has the additives that make it all stick together.
Got it.
Does that look like the right consistency?
This is beautiful. And it's nice and tender, so this is why this is where we want to refrigerate.
Okay, so you would take it out. You don't have to do that.
Okay.
Our wonderful kitchen has already done it.
And so then it makes the noise. It goes... Here we go.
And
then you refrigerate?
Yes, and then we refrigerate.
Okay.
So we're going to pull this out. That's my favorite part. Okay. So we'll grab this.
Okay, I'll shut that.
And look how pretty.
Beautiful.
And it doesn't have to be this pretty at home. You do not have to make it this insanely gorgeous. Just roll them out at home.
Now, how long should the...
Look at how cool that is.
Wow. How long should we leave the dough in the refrigerator?
At least 30 minutes. Okay. So the idea is you're chilling the butter and the egg down, okay, and you're getting it to hold its shape. Because right now, it's so tender.
It would just fall apart.
It would
fall apart.
It's delicious to eat right now, though.
I was thinking about that.
You can totally just eat it. And then we're going to cut out our little hearts. Isn't it so tasty? Mm. And then that's go right to the pan.
But I know it should be in the refrigerator for 30 minutes, but how long do you think it would actually keep in the fridge if you weren't going to make them?
I think you can keep it in there for up to a week.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think, I think that that's fine. So we're going to put them over here. And then I skip a little step. So here, we're going to cut out all of our pretty little hearts.
So you need two different
cutters.
Sizes.
So I'm just going to make one more, and then I'll show you how cute. Okay.
Now, this is just like a general question here for a guy who doesn't really make cookies all that often.
Yeah.
Now, can you kind of jam these together? I see you're leaving spaces around the cutout.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Could you, like, maximize?
You're such an engineer.
No, I'm
like
looking at
wasted material.
That's exactly what's happening in my mind.
As
right now.
You should.
Is that the idea?
Yeah, that's the idea.
Okay.
But you know
feel
what?
Better.
Just to
feel
show.
Better.
No, you know what? It's really smart because then you can even leave room right here.
Oh, like, see, I didn't know what you
want.
See that?
You can do this is on the fly, guys.
And you know what else? Afterwards, whatever those little extra bits are, you can roll it back out and make a few more cookies.
Yeah.
You know?
And the idea is even numbers because you have to have a bottom and you have to have a top.
Right. Oh.
So that's the most important part. So here's a little deal. And so here we've got two. Oh, I need one more because I want them to be even.
Oh, here you go. I took your cookie cutter.
Sorry. I was like, what did I do with
it? I've stolen your heart.
You have many a time over.
I hoped you'd pick that up.
All right.
All right. So now we pop these in the oven for how long?
These are going to cook for 8 to 10 minutes, so we just want to make sure that we have enough tops and bottoms.
And at what temperature?
Trade. These are going to go in at 350 degrees.
Okay.
And so we have some beautifully baked ones.
So that's pretty quick, 8 to 10 minutes.
Isn't that cute? Look at that. And then we'll set this little guy aside.
All right. And now we build.
Yeah. And now we build. This is the best part, you guys. I feel like all of the work is leading up to the super fun part, and then you're going to do some, and I'm going to do some.
Fun.
Isn't this cute? And then we always powder sugar these cute little hearts.
And these cookies are great on their own, by
the way.
If you don't like the jam in the middle,
you don't have to do
it.
You don't have
to
do that.
With some tea.
Yeah.
Because it's not too sweet.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And it's crumbly and buttery.
Yeah.
And those are the things that we love in life, right?
Exactly.
Crumbles and butter. Okay. So here, as we all know, this is my favorite thing to do ever. And I feel like if you're having a hard day, if life is, you know, really overtaking you, get some powdered sugar.
It's cheaper than therapy.
It is cheaper than, I just saved you $175.
Right there.
I'm not joking.
So do you need to do the powdered sugar while it's still warm so it sticks or no?
No. And you can do, if you like a real thick layer of powdered sugar, if you do it when it's warm, it sort of melts and almost creates an icing, and you want to double do it.
Ooh, that's
it's
right.
It's tasty. It's not bad.
Right,
but you
but
can cool them
icing,
off.
You're right.
And then I like to ice these little guys.
So
and
you
I
want
save
to do
some
this
for you.
And you, oh,
yeah.
Me?
Yeah.
Just to eat?
No.
I'm happy to do that. But I love.
Sprinkle.
But also, it's important, I think, to mention to them that you have to do the. Do the powdered sugar before you build.
Before you build.
Oh, yeah.
Because otherwise, if you do it afterwards, you're going to miss that cute little stained glass.
Yeah.
So this is what we're going to do. So
Let's
cute.
See this. That
so here's our jam.
Delicious.
Oh,
and you don't want to go to the whole
edge.
Oh,
I thought you put it together first.
Yes.
Oh.
Isn't this so cute?
Gotcha.
And if you didn't want to use raspberry jam, you could use any kind, right?
Any jam. You don't want to go to the whole edge because you don't want to spill out.
Okay.
And then you take your little top.
And would you make your own jam?
Together.
You can totally make your own jam. Look at
That's
this.
My jam.
And then look at when you squish it just a little bit, it sort of like pumps up. It's so cute.
It's adorable.
You
I'm
know
so
you
proud.
Make one, Deb.
Oh my gosh,
you
I want
you
gotta make one.
Deb.
You should,
yeah.
I want to make these for Alexandra's
She'd
teachers.
Love,
for the
you guys.
Teachers, right?
And if you are going to use them as a gift, let them overnight cure. So that's going to mean that the jam's going to take on. It's going to set. And then when you put them into a little baggie, they won't go everywhere and separate. So if you're going to give them to a teacher, you're going to definitely want
them. Do they need to be refrigerated because of the jam or no?
Not at all. There's enough sugar in there.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Okay.
How cute.
Have a bite. You guys get a taste too.
Yeah.
We've been eating.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
So cute.
Super yummy. You're
going to
love them.
Oh, they're so yummy.
Full recipe, of course, as Debbie's taking a bite, go to hallmarkchannel.com.
Yes.
It'll all be right.
It's so cute.
You got to do it, though. You got to do it.
Cheers.
Take a little cheers.
So cute.
And for more from Danielle, just visit rusticjoyfulfood.com.
Oh, so
what we're talking about, Deb.
It's so good.
It's so yummy.
Absolutely tasty.
It feels healthy. Am I wrong? Mm-hmm.
No. It is healthy. Protein and fruit.
Yeah.
It's a salad.
Absolutely.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Ken, you're up next. What do you got?
All right, do you have a piece of furniture that you're really not into anymore, like your dining room table? Well, that's the way I felt about ours, so I gave it a little makeover. It's coming up next.